it's very straightforward, and why you don't seem to be able to understand it is somewhat strange to me. Nephilim quoted sections of a scientific paper.
Apparently, dprjones thinks it's okay for secular scientists to quote and cite each other's work, but if a creationist cites a portion of a scientist's work, then it's cherry-picking and dishonest. I'm going to show you something astounding here, DPR. You're about to learn a lesson in how people work when it comes to science. Each one of these blue boxes you see is a reference to another scientist's work in this paper as supporting evidence for their statements. They don't provide the entire paper. They don't read the entire thing. They cite conclusions of other scientists and cite the work in which they come to that conclusion based upon their research. The number of citations, you might call them quotations. I did not quote them, by the way. I paraphrased their statement. Here's another, and yet another, and another. I'm telling you what, the number of times they cite the work of other scientists in this paper is phenomenal. Here's another, and another, and another. I'm bypassing some of these. There's another. I'm not going to go through this whole paper and provide you how many times. It would take too long. I'm not going to spend that much time making video demonstrating how many times they cite the work of other scientists in this paper. There's another, and another, and there's another, and 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 again. And here again, and here again, and again, and again, and again, and again, and again. Here's another one, and another one, and another one, and another, and again, and again, and again, and again, and again. There are dozens. I have looked through this whole paper to see. There are probably 50 to 100 citations of the work of other scientists in this paper. There's one more. There's another one. Here's another. Here he talks about Dr. This one, he said, this one, and blah, blah, blah. And another. And another, and another, and another, and another. Here's another one, and another one. And here's again, and 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 another one, and another one, and another one, and another one. And again, and again, and again, and again. Here's another one. Look how far down here I am. I'm not even halfway through this paper. There are dozens and dozens and dozens of references to the works of other scientists in this paper. The paper is filled with them. Filled with references to other works by other scientists. dprjones, get this through your head. I do not have to paste into this any paper I write. I do not have to read every word of another scientist's paper before I can cite what they have to say. This is how people work in science. Do you understand that? If the people that wrote this paper did that, this would not be a paper. It would be a massive book.
You made a YouTube video fairly recently.
Yes.
in which you referred to that paper, although you didn't actually give a reference to it.
I want to read a little something that's very interesting from the Journal of Cosmology. This is very interesting. It states, they've made several assertions, as you know, in their recent publication of the journal that things that creationists have been saying for a long time, that life couldn't have arisen on the Earth because of the environment of the Earth. You know, contrary to what the evolutionists have been pumping into the heads of everybody in school books and whatnot for the last who knows how many decades, right? Now they're coming around to the creation model with this, but they're refusing to acknowledge life could have been created, of course.
You see, this is why people think that you are dishonest, Sporty. That paper says that the age of the universe is 14.5 billion years old. You have cherry-picked one part of that paper to try and support your argument. Do you not think that that is dishonest?
DPR Jones, let's understand something here, because you don't seem to be much of a thinker. Their paper states, life could not have begun on Earth. Emphatic statement. Point number two. And point number three, they state, and I quote, I'm not cherry-picking, statistics and complexity, not enough time for life to be fashioned on Earth. There is evidence of biological and microbial activity in the oldest rocks on Earth, dated to over 4.2 billion years. Oh, look, they're quoting another scientist. Are they dishonest and cherry-picking? And in statement number three, they state, the statistical probability of random fashioning of one gene from random combinations, all of its constituent elements, is more than one chance in 100 million trillion. Yes, perhaps through random mixing, life could have been created on this planet within 100 trillion years, perhaps even within 100 billion. DPR Jones, you non-thinker, you, what you're not understanding is that they are stating that within the period of time that they believe this Earth has existed, life could not have arisen by natural means. There is not enough time. They're well aware of what they believe the age of the Earth is. Let's look again at this statement. Statistics and complexity, not enough time for life to be fashioned on the Earth. The very next sentence in their paper states, there is evidence of biological and microbial activity in the oldest rocks of the Earth, dated to over 4.2 billion years. Clearly they know what they're saying, DPR Jones. It's you who don't know what they're saying. You're just looking for something to complain about. They are stating that within the lifespan of this Earth, according to them, which is 4.2 billion years, but fallacious, life could not have arisen on the Earth within that amount of time, or even in a vastly greater amount of time, many folds over time. Do you not understand? Maybe now you see how you've made a buffoon of yourself by going off with your mouth, ranting and complaining about a creationist, first off, without understanding what it is you're complaining about. You know what happened here? You got overly emotional and upset by this evidence provided by secular sources, which is coming to the conclusion that life couldn't have arisen by abiogenesis on the Earth. And that upsets you so much because it goes against your paradigm, because you're not willing to make yourself look like a complete moron like Richard Dawkins has, and some other scientists, actually evolutionist scientists, have, and say, well, life began in the stars and then came here. You see, because that is completely absurd to believe such a thing. I mean, you have to believe, first of all, that a rock can shoot through the atmosphere of the Earth and get white hot as it's coming into the Earth atmosphere, and a bacteria inside that Earth can survive that temperature and then live once that rock slams into the Earth at 11,000 miles an hour. Do you believe that? See, that's not rational, is it? And you don't want to believe that. But science is demonstrating life can arise on the Earth. It couldn't have. And secular sources are now coming to that conclusion because science demonstrates it so clearly. They're being made to admit it. Do you not see that? But see, this upsets you so much because you don't want to go off on some insane diatribe like Richard Dawkins has and say, life came from the stars, which is what these idiots here are doing. So this upsets you so much because if life couldn't have arisen on the earth, it looks like God created it. But that upsets you so much that you attacked the paper, you attacked me and called me dishonest, you said I was cherry-picking for providing what these scientists say. You didn't think because you're a non-thinker. And you've buffooned yourself.
You see, this is why people think that you are dishonest, Sporty. That paper says that the age of the universe is 14.5 billion years old. You have cherry-picked one part of that paper to try and support your argument, your argument, your argument.
You say it's my argument. I'm quoting them. I concur. So, TPR Jones, let me ask you this. Is this indicative of the level of intellect you put into your videos and the things you say in your videos? Because you make videos in which you badmouth God, you badmouth Christianity, you badmouth creationism, and you support evolutionism and atheism as though it was supposedly correct and philosophically true. And is this indicative of the level of intellect, the knowledge, the research, the comprehension, the correlation of knowledge and information that you put into your work? Because I got to tell you, pal, if it is, Sporty, you're a failure not only to your own little tiny cult of God denialists around the world, but you're also a failure to yourself when it comes to this. Because I can't imagine anybody who is just a mouth behind a camera with nothing going on upstairs. If you have something intellectual to say and you expect other people to listen to what you say and have take any heed to what you say, as though it's any kind of truth, scientific or philosophical truth to what you have to say, you need to start doing a better job, Sporty. So, DPR Jones, you are now the newest recipient of the prestigious and esteemed NephilimFree's Diminutive Evo Head Award for Excellence in Non-Thinking and Science Denialism. Congratulations.